I know a lot of you guys have been asking about my distro, what DE and WM I'm using, what themes and icon packs, so I decided to just show you. All cards on the table now and links in the description. We're gonna set it all up from scratch and then talk a little bit about how to automate all of this in the future, what racing is, and why you should probably stop calling it that. Welcome to aunetx. I am Nick, and this is... How's it going, guys? Let me just come clean first. I did not know why we say ricing. Didn't know where rice comes from. I knew it was called that way. I didn't know why. As far as distro customizations go, ricing has probably been around for as long as or even longer than r/unixborn has, which is a little over 10 years now. I've been there, I said it and done it. I never questioned it until now. So just in case you're in the same boat as me, rice is an acronym for race-inspired cosmetic enhancements. More commonly used to refer to modifications that are considered excessive or focused on aesthetics rather than functionality or efficiency. That being said, if you've been checking out my channel, you probably already know that I like my distro like my coffee, black and with very little sugar. I came to PopOS a few years ago after an entire year of distro hopping. PopOS is the distro developed by System76. I found it to be stable with good driver and software support. The default desktop environment is Gnome. So it was a pretty clean, polished, minimal experience to begin with, which is one of the things that I was looking for, and you're about to see how easy it is to make it a little bit more yours. So let's get this thing popping. I removed all my theme files and extensions, so this should be pretty close to what Gnome feels like right out of the box. I'm gonna grab a wallpaper from Unsplash. I'm looking for something abstract, landscape and free. Going for this one, download. Right click and set as wallpaper, that's also control F8. And we can see that it already looks a lot better. Next, we're gonna jump right into theming, but for that we need to make sure that we have an extension for the shell that's named user themes. You may want to install the complimentary browser extension that would allow you to use a toggle on each one of these pages to install and activate shell extensions directly. The extension allows Gnome to look in the user directory for themes and icons in addition to the shared path. Gotta refresh the page and there you have it. Now we can check user themes. Got the toggle right there. I'm using the Dracula theme for my desktop interface, so we can grab it from draculatheme.com. Look for GDK in the search box and we're gonna download the zip file from GitHub. Gonna want to make sure that we have two directories named .themes and .icons in our home directory. In Nautilus, you can press Ctrl-H to toggle hidden files. Right-click to make the first directory. You can also press Ctrl-Shift-N to make another one. And now I'm going to drag and drop the main directory from the zip into .themes. Let's click and hold and Alt-Tab to find the other window and release. F2 to rename it, and we're gonna call it Dracula. We could run these commands to set the theme, but I want to show you the tweak tool for Gnome. If you don't have it installed, that's gnome-tweaks. It's got a bunch of useful stuff, but we're gonna wanna look at the Appearance tab where we get to set the theme for applications and shell. Something's already changed, but you will want to log out and back in for everything to be all right. Alright, now we can grab an icon pack and some cursors since we're there. This is gnomelook.org. I'm just going to type in Flattery since that's the name of the pack that I'm using. And I'm getting the Indigo one. Jump on over to cursors on the left to look for Mojave. There's a subtle difference from what we have here. Now we're going to extract both of these into the .icons directory that we created earlier. And if we open the tweak tool again, it's going to show up there and we can start using them. You probably noticed inconsistent designs in the shell around the borders of the dock, some of the menus. We're gonna fix that right away by actually using a different theme for the shell. The theme that I'm looking for is called Sweet, And we're gonna grab the dark version, V40. And we're gonna extract this in the themes directory. We can close all of this and open the tweak tool again to set the shell theme to this one. And there are subtle differences here, but all the visual glitches are gone. It's a lot better now. All right, now it's time to install the main extension that we're using here. It's called dash to panel. Just gonna toggle it here, and you can already see it that it took away our dock and put all the icons here. We're gonna disable these old extensions here. Everything else stays the same. We can turn off these like that and unpin the first three icons since we're not going to be using them anymore. I obviously customized my extension a lot. If you think that these particular settings would be of any use to you, just let me know in the comments and I will export this file and upload it somewhere and drop a link in the description. You can find links to all of the GNOME shell extensions that I use in the description, but before moving on, I wanted to show you another one that actually comes with Pop! OS, and it's this little button here on the panel. You can use it for window tiling. It's a popular feature, a lot of people find it very useful, and it's nice to just have that option in GNOME. The next thing we can do is to use a color scheme generator for our terminal. This is Go, as in Vincent. I'm copying this command to the clipboard because we're gonna run it soon. Here's a list of all the available themes, and I've already set my eyes on Arthur. I'm gonna run the command now, which will download and execute an install script looking for Arthur. That is on number 9. I'm gonna put it here, and now I can use this new profile that got generated for Tilex. And let me just show you a little bit of JS and Vim to see some colors. Time we talk a little bit about dconf. It stands for desktop configuration and is a system that is primarily used by desktop environments such as GNOME. If you're not familiar with it, you can think of it as the registry editor in Windows. A lot of system and application settings are stored here, and we can use the CLI to export all of these settings and import them later. Here are a few options that we can use, and because real men test in production, I am now going to reset all of my settings and attempt to restore them. My terminal is still open on a different monitor, I'm restoring everything, and as soon as the UI unfreezes, I'm gonna bring it over again. Well, use it safely and wisely. I really hope you found some of this stuff here useful. I want to thank all of you for your continued support, which basically made this channel blow up almost overnight. It's really nice to see so many people getting involved, so let's keep this up. Thank you so much for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.